SBIRT is actually a evidence-based practice model that looks at system change and incorporates how can we improve identifying patients who are having harmful patterns of use for alcohol and other drugs. Dr. Yamika Stevens, I am the Graduate Program Director for the Psychiatric Nurse Practitioner Program here in the College of Nursing at Wayne State, and I'm also a principal investigator on an SBIRT training grant that trains social work students, nursing students, and healthcare professionals on how to use SBIRT in practice. So I use SBIRT actually in my training of my students and actually in my practice. So I currently work as part of the CO service for Henry Ford Health System, and I work in a private practice. And I utilize SBIRT, the screenings, and the intervention in both of my practices.
Because typically, what do we spend a whole bunch of time doing? Trying to figure out how we're going to get them to change. You could just ask them. What would it take for you to be an 8?
A miracle. All right, miracles. Okay, so we need prayer. That's my answer. They say a miracle. Prayer.
So SBIRT has actually been around for a long time. It was actually developed in the early 1980s by the World Health Organization, and it's been here in the U.S. Predominantly since about 2003. It's been funded by SAMHSA, which is the Substance Abuse Administration. And so there have been state level grants and very similar training grants to the ones we have to increase the use amongst providers. So I've actually been using SBIRT now for about 4 years. I have been doing the audit as a part of my normal practice, but I've been using the actual full SBIRT tools for about the last 4 years as a part of this training grant. So harm reduction actually, typically in most of any like public health model, you have something that's either abstinence. So we know very much about abstinence-based models. Harm reduction actually looks at, we say that we understand that you are going to have a pattern of use. So say if you drink, versus telling somebody they have to stop drinking, our harm reduction model would say, how can we reduce your drinking to actually reduce the overall harm that the patient would have as related to their health conditions. So we know that if you drink 6 days a week and we get you to drink 3 days a week, then we've actually reduced the harm that you're doing to yourself by about 50%.
This is really what we're talking about SBIRT, this is identifying risk. So this would be an ER, this would be in an outpatient center. Like it wouldn't necessarily be on a substance abuse side because there's a whole different set of parameters if you're actually working this up.
So let me ask you this.
It really was, as I started with this grant, I realized that it was such a necessary skill set that was needed to for not only for my personal practice, but also for how I train my students. Especially as we see this current opioid crisis, we really need to be able to create providers that understand how to assess their patients and how do we actually be able to engage them so that we can actually decrease their harmful use. You can actually train anyone. You don't have to have a degree. You can have a lay person. You can do it in churches. It can actually be utilized in any mechanism. It's a very flexible model. It actually has a lot of, I kind of think of it like a Lego system. You take the pieces that work well for your practice, but you are always able to keep the core components and impact their overall use. So when you think about the fact that I can have SBIRT in my church, I can have it at my school, I can receive SBIRT services in the ER, it makes it effective because it is so flexible. So it's not just when you go to see your doctor, you actually can have an SBIRT intervention in the places that people actually would probably be a little bit more open to listening.
What a typical day is like for you? Because sometimes you, once they start to talk about all their stressors, all the things that overwhelm them, and how the substance fits in to that stress relief, it helps you to understand what kind of connection they've made to substance use. So it does help.
I really think SBIRT in the next 5 to 10 years will actually even take off even further. I mean, we've seen a lot of improve or increase in use since 2003, but especially now that we have this current opioid crisis, providers are really seeking out a way to engage patients and have a conversation that they don't always feel like they were really trained to do. And so having an opportunity to do something like SBIRT, it really helps to decrease a provider's anxiety, but also to give them a skill set that's really going to impact our current opioid crisis. So I really see in the next 5 to 10 years that it'll be something that becomes a natural part of practice. So my advice to social work, nursing students, or anyone who's just starting out using SBIRT is to really be patient with yourself. This is a really new skill set, and it's a skill set that creates some anxiety in people. So you really have to give yourself a time to practice it and really be open and let your patients know, okay, this is something that we're doing new, explaining them whether that this may be your first or second time doing it, and that you are still learning this skill set, but how important it is for their overall health. So just be patient with yourself and give yourself some time to practice.
This is actually across 10 countries, and it was specifically looking at alcohol, and what they found is that even after 5 minutes, they got about 20% of people to reduce their use. with 5 minutes. Because what's the other thing that people in healthcare always say we don't have? Time. I don't have time to be in there for 30 minutes talking to somebody about their addiction. You don't need 30 minutes. This intervention can be done in 10 minutes or less.
If someone's interested in learning more about SBIRT, if they could just visit the website listed below, it's for SAMHSA, and it will give them a whole host of resources and tools and also information about finding about trainings in their area.